Hello students, welcome to accountancy class. Today I'll be taking up chapter 1 under part 2, accounting for share capital. In this chapter we are going to study about meaning of company, meaning of shares, features of company, types of shares and the categories of share capital and the problems related to issue of share capital. In this chapter, for the public examination, questions appear under 1 mark, 2 mark and problems for 12 marks. And this chapter is not new to you. Under first year PUC in business studies, you studied once the theory part of this chapter. So let us study one by one. First let us learn meaning of company. A company is an artificial person having corporate legal entity distinct from its members and has a common seal used for its signature. Okay. Company is an artificial person, means like human beings, a company can also issue money or borrow money, can own property in its own name. That is why it is known as artificial person having corporate legal entity, means it has its own existence under Companies Act, distinct from its members, means the members and the company are considered as two separate parties, and has a common seal. Every company has its own seal and it is used for its signature, used as a signature in the main document of the company. So it has a common seal used for its signature. This is the meaning of company. Company is an artificial person and has corporate legal entity separate from its members and common seal is used for the signature, used as a signature. Now let us study the features of a company. First feature is that body corporate. In India, company comes into existence as per company's law or as per Companies Act. That is why company has body corporate. Then separate legal entity. Business and its members are considered as two separate parties. Okay. Business and its members. Members here means shareholders are considered as two separate parties. That is why separate legal entity. Company has its own existence. Limited liability. The liability of the members of the company is limited to the extent of shares held by them. Okay. The liability of the shareholders is limited only to the extent of shares held by them. That is why the members have limited liability. Perpetual succession means continuous existence. Any member may come and any member may go. The company runs forever. So, in spite of the difference in membership of the company runs forever. That is why it is known as perpetual succession. Common seal. Every company has its own seal and it is used as a signature. Company's authorized signature. And it is used in the main document of the company. That is why company has its own common seal. Then, transferability of shares means shares of a public limited company are easily transferable. So these are the main features of a company which we studied in detail once in business studies. Now let us study the meaning of share. A share is a fractional part of the share capital of a company. A share is a fractional part of the share capital of a company and the holders of share are also called as owners of the company. For example, company has or company requires rupees 10 lakh capital, then that time this 10 lakh rupees is subdivided into 1 lakh units, okay, of rupees 10 each. So the company requires rupees 10 lakh, and this 10 lakh is divided into 1 lakh units, means fractional units. Each cost is rupees 10 lakh. Here number of shares are 1 lakh and the cost of each share is rupees 10. That time it is possible for the company to raise rupees 10 lakh. So share capital of a company is divided into fractional unit. Each of these unit are called as shares. In this example, the cost of each share is rupees 10. And those who hold the shares or those who possess the shares are also called as shareholders of the company. Now, types of shares. First one is equity shares, and the second one is preference shares. Equity shares are those shares which do not enjoy preferential rights at the time of payment of dividend and at the time of repayment of capital. Okay? Those shares which do not enjoy preferential rights at the time of payment of dividend and also at the time of repayment of share capital are called as equity shares. And those who possess equity shares are also called as owners of the company. And preference shares means they enjoy preferential rights over the payment of dividend and also at the time of repayment of capital, at the time of winding up of the company. So these two are the types of shares. Now, meaning of share capital. Amount collected by the company from its members is called as share capital. Okay. Amount collected through the issue of shares is called as share capital. Here in this example, by issuing 1 lakh shares at rupees 10 each, company gets rupees 10 lakh. So this 10 lakh is called as share capital of the company. So amount collected by the company by issuing shares are called as share capital of the company. Let us study about issue of shares. A public company collects amount from its members through the issue of shares, and while collecting the money from its members, generally it follows four steps. Okay. In that first stage is called as application stage. Second stage is called as allotment. Third one is called as first call, or if any next installment is there, then it is called as second call, and so on. Okay. While collecting money from the shareholders, company generally receives it in installments. Those installments are generally called as application money, allotment money, first call money, second call money. If there is more installments, then third call, so on. So like this, company collects money from its shareholders. Now let us study one by one what is this application money. So in my previous example, per share it costs rupees 10. Company generally not collects rupees 10 at once. It collects it in installments. For example, in the first installment it collects rupees 2, and in the second installment it collects rupees 3. And if there is only one stage, that is only first call stage, then in the last stage it collects remaining 5, then it will become rupees 10, right? Now what is this application stage? Application money means money received at the time of receiving application. So in my this example, I received 1 lakh shares into rupees 2, that is rupees 2 lakh I received. So that money, rupees 2 lakh, is called as application money. Similarly, after receiving the application, after some time, the company once again go for allotment of shares. What is this allotment? Okay, allotment means allotting or giving the shares to the applicants who applied for the shares. In this allotment stage, the decisions of the directors is important. Here, the directors go for allotment only if the applications reached the minimum subscription level. Okay, only if the company received application for minimum subscription, that is at least 90% of the subscription is received from the public, means applied for the shares, that time only we can go for allotment of shares. So here, first condition is that minimum subscription level must be reached. Then, while making allotment of shares, the directors have wide power, means they can allot full shares to those who applied, or they can make part payment of the shares to them, or otherwise they can reject the shares, reject the applications without saying or without giving any reason. So here, director's decision is important. Then, after the allotment of shares, the company issues letter of allotment to the applicants. In that letter of allotment, the company mentions the number of shares applied to the applicants, and similarly, the amount of money which the applicants have to pay for the company. So in this letter of allotment, they mention what is the amount of money to be given to the company by the applicants. So the amount payable by the company, the amount payable by the applicants to the company in this stage, in allotment stage, is called as allotment money. Okay, the amount payable by the applicants to the company in the allotment stage is called as allotment money. After allotting the money, after allotting the shares to the applicants, the members are called as shareholders of the company. Okay, after allotting the shares to the members, then that members are called as shareholders of the company. So this is about the second stage, that is allotment. Now the third one is calls on shares. It may be first call, it may be second call, and so on. What is this calls? The installments demanded by the company from the shareholders are called as calls on shares. Now in this example, the company yet to receive rupees 5 from shareholders, right? So company calls for this rupees 5 from the shareholders, that is called as first call or second call, and so on. So in this, here the shareholders have to pay the next installment, that is the pending amount, rupees 5, to the company, that is called as call or first call or second call, etc. So this is about issue of shares. Company generally issues in three stages. Company generally receives the share money in three stages, that is first one is application stage, second one allotment stage, and the third one is first call or second call, and so on. Now these shares can be issued in three ways, that is issue of shares at par, issue of shares at par, and issue of shares at premium, and issue of shares at discount. what is this issue of share set par means? When the company issues shares at a price which is equal to the nominal value of the shares, okay? When a company issues its shares which is equal to the nominal value or face value of the shares, then it is called as issue of shares at par, okay? In our example, share cost rupees 10. So, if the company issues its share at rupees 10 itself, then it is called as issue of shares at par. Then what is the meaning of issue of shares at premium? It means issuing the shares at a price which is more than the face value, okay? Issuing a shares at a price which is more than the face value. Actually, our face value of the share is rupees 10, but the company issues here at rupees 12. 2 rupees is the premium there. 12 minus 10, 2 is considered as premium. Now, my question is, in which case the company can issue its shares at premium? Yes, when there is more demand for the shares of the company, then the company issues its shares at premium, okay? Now, the third case is issue of shares at discount. It means issue of shares at a price which is lower than the face value of the shares. This is the face value, but the company issues its shares at a lower price. It may be rupees 8 or it may be rupees 9. When the company issues its shares at lower prices? Yes, when there is no demand for the shares of the company, then the company issues its shares at lower prices. So, these are the three conditions, and about the first two situations, we have to learn how to solve the or how to pass the journal entries. In second year PUC, in this chapter itself, we are studying how to pass the journal entries in these two situations. How the public comes to know that such a company issued its shares to the public? How the people comes to know? Yes, it comes to know through the prospectus. Then what is prospectus? Prospectus means invitation to the public to subscribe the shares of the company, okay? Company invites the public, invites the people to purchase the shares of the company. It is called as prospectus. Detailed information is available in the prospectus about the company, okay? So, through this, the public comes to know that such a type of company is issuing shares. Now, categories of share capital. First one is authorized capital. It is that part of the share capital which a company is authorized to raise through issue of shares, okay? It is that part of the share capital which a company is authorized to raise through the issue of shares. For example, rupees 10 lakh is authorized to raise to a company, and this authorized share capital is mentioned under capital clause of the memorandum of association. That is why authorized capital means it is a share capital which is authorized to raise from the public through the issue of shares. Now, for example, by issuing 1 lakh shares, a company is authorized to raise rupees 10 lakh from the public, okay? Each share costs rupees 10, and by issuing 1 lakh shares the company can raise rupees 10 lakh. This is the authorized share capital. Permission is given to a company, you can raise this much share capital through the issue of shares. Okay. Now the second one is issued capital. It is that part of the authorized capital which is actually issued to the public. Even though we got permission to raise rupees 10 lakh from the public by issuing shares, it is not necessary that we have to issue 1 lakh shares and we have to collect 10 lakh rupees from the public. It is our wish. As per our wish, we can raise amount from the public through the issue of shares. So, we have decided to give 80,000 shares of rupees 10 and decided to collect 8 lakh rupees from the public. Okay. Now it is that part of the authorized capital which is actually issued to the public to raise money. Here, by issuing 80,000 shares, per share 10 rupees, we raised rupees 8 lakh from the public. Now the third one is subscribed capital. Even though the company issued 80,000 shares, it is not necessary that public has to subscribe all these 80,000 shares. Sometimes there may be less applicants to the shares also. Then what is the meaning of subscribed capital? It means it is that part of the issued capital which is actually subscribed by the public. Now the company may subscribe or the public may apply for only 60,000 shares of rupees 10. Even though we issued 80,000 shares, public applied for only 60,000 shares. That means the company received here rupees 6 lakh. Okay. Then it is called as subscribed capital. Now subscribed capital means it is that part of the issued capital which is actually subscribed by the public. Here the company received application for only 60,000 shares. Then that money is called as subscribed capital. Next one is called up capital. It is that part of the subscribed capital which is actually called up by the company. Now the shareholders have to pay rupees 6 lakh to the company, but they can pay this rupees 6 lakh in installments. Now the company called up for allotment stage. Up to allotment, the shareholders have to pay their money. Then that time the company receives 60,000 shares into rupees 5. Company receives here 3 lakh rupees. Okay, company called up here for 3 lakh rupees. That time the shareholders have to pay their second stage money, that is allotment, up to allotment, that is rupees 5. Now the company gets here 3 lakh. It is called as called up capital. Next one is paid up capital. Paid up capital means it is that part of the called up capital which is actually paid up by the shareholders. Now here in the fourth stage, company called up for 3 lakh rupees, but here the public paid only rupees 2,95,000. Means one shareholder who is having 1,000 shares not paid rupees 5. That is why the company received only rupees 2,95,000. Okay. It is that part of the called up capital which is paid by the shareholders. Here we not received 1000 shares money of rupees 5, that is 5000 rupees not received. Then that money which is not received by the company is called as calls in arrears. Okay, here in this example, one shareholder who is having 1000 shares not paid rupees 5, means 5000 rupees is pending, that is why that 5000 is called as calls in arrears. Then what is the meaning of calls in arrears? It means the money which is not received by the company on calls or on allotment are called as calls in arrears. What is this forfeiture of shares? It means cancellation of the rights of the shareholders for the non-payment of allotment money or call money or both. In my previous example, one shareholder who is having 1000 shares not paid rupees 5, so rupees 5000 is pending, so the company has the right to forfeit or cancel these 1000 shares. Okay, after cancelling those 1000 shares, the company can reissue that shares to some other person at a discount. So forfeiture of shares means cancellation of the rights of the shareholders. Now let us study about oversubscription. What is this oversubscription? When the company receives applications more than the applications it offered to the public. Okay. In my previous example, company issued application for 1 lakh shares, but the company received application for 1,10,000 shares. Now this 10,000 is extra here, this 10,000 is called as oversubscription. Okay, company received application for more number of shares, it is called as oversubscription. Then what is the meaning of undersubscription? When the company receives application less than the number of shares which is offered to the public for subscription. For example, even though the company issued 1 lakh applications to the public, it received only 90,000 applications from the people or from the members, then it is called as undersubscription. Means it received application for less than the number of shares allotted to the public for subscription, then it is called as undersubscription. In both these oversubscription and undersubscription, we have to solve problems. I'll tell you in the next class how to solve the or how to pass the journal entries in the case of oversubscription or undersubscription. Issue of shares for consideration other than cash, what it is? It means issue of shares by the company to the vendors, means to the suppliers, when it purchases fixed assets like land, buildings, etc. Other than paying cash, the company issues shares to the vendors, then it is called as issue of shares for consideration other than cash. Now let us study how to pass the journal entries in various situations. First stage is receiving application money. So for recording entries while receiving application money, First entry is for receiving application money. When a company receives application money in lump sum, then it directly goes to the bank account of the company. That is why to debit bank account debtor to, through which way or for what we are receiving that application money, bank account debtor to share application account. Okay, bank account debtor to share application account, we are receiving money, that's why bank account through or by the way of application, that is why we are crediting share application account. This is the entry for receiving application money. Now after receiving the application money, we have to transfer that application money to share capital account. That is the second one. For transferring application money from share application account, we are transferring it to share capital account. That is why we need to debit share application account and we need to credit share capital account. Entry is share application account debtor to share capital account. Okay, these two entries required to pass in the first stage, that is under application stage, for receiving bank account debtor to share application account, for transferring application money to share capital account, share application account debtor to share capital account. Now the second stage is allotment stage. When the allotment money is due, means company not received allotment money. So when the allotment money is due, we need to debit share allotment account debtor to share capital account. Company still not received allotment money is due, that is why share allotment account debtor to share capital account. Now the next one is company received allotment money. Okay, when company received allotment money, once again the company receives it in lump sum, it directly goes to the bank account of the company. That is why debit what comes in bank account debtor to, for what we are receiving the money, we are receiving allotment money, that is why we have to credit that bank account debtor to share allotment account. Okay, this is the second stage, bank account debtor to share allotment account. Now the third stage, on calls. For call money due, for call money due means first call or final call money is yet not received, company has to receive that. That is why concerned share call account debtor, concerned share call account debtor to share capital account, concerned share call account debtor to share capital account means call money is not received, call money is due, that is why it may be first share first call account debtor to share capital account or share final call account debtor to share capital account. Now next entry is call money is received. Okay, when the company receives money, debit bank account debtor to concerned share call account. Bank account debtor to concerned share call account. This is for call money due, and when the company receives call money, bank account debtor to concerned share call account. It may be to first call account or to share final call account. These are the six entries which we need to pass when we are issuing shares at par. These are the simple entries. There are still more entries that I will explain in my next class. So that's all for today. Thank you.